Daniel, Skits is doing it again.
Did he start when you entered the room?
See, why is he doing that?
Itchy back?
Only when we enter the room?
Showing off his new worm imitation?
Hi.
Helen, can you interpret this?
Interpret? You mean you want me to try to explain what he's doing?
Yes.
I can't tell what he wants, but whatever it is, it's pretty cute. In a skitsy way.
I'll call the vet. Maybe she can understand skits.
You know, Martha could just ask him.
Of course. That's even better. And it's free. Martha?
No problem. Interpreter dog on the case. Skits, the people can't comprehend why you're doing the you know, doofy rolling. Comprehend? Oh, a comprehend is when you understand something. It makes sense to you. They don't understand what you're doing. Uh-huh. Yeah, I see. Okay, yeah, I understand.
Is it worms? Do we have to deworm him?
No. He says he used to have a rubber plum that he played with upside down.
Oh, yeah, Plummy.
He thought if you saw him doing this, you would interpret it to mean he wants a new one.
You want the new Plummy, Skits?
Wow! Once it's translated from dog language to human language, it seems so obvious. Want to carry it home, Skits?
You're welcome, Skits.
Helen, your dog's tongue is all swollen, and it's squeaking.
That's a rubber plum, Alice.
Dog toys are weird.
Weird!
Well, I'm here to buy something non-weird. Polly wants a seed stick.
Seed stick?
Mm-mm, no, he doesn't. Allow me to translate from parrot into English. Me wants a mirror. Hey, awful grammar.
He said seed stick.
He was parroting you, and then he squawked, me wants a mirror.
You know Martha can translate animal talk, Alice. She told us what Skits wanted, and look how happy he is.
There is such a thing as too happy.
A young lady and talking dog.
Oh, he probably means us.
Hello, I'm Laszlo Hucky, and this is my dog, Slappy. Is it true your dog translates what animals say?
Martha understands most animals.
Could she tell me what's bothering Slappy? She seems even less happy than usual.
Slappy, let's have a conversation. A conversation is a talk between you and me. What's the matter? Slappy's unhappy because her ears dip in the water when she drinks. She needs water at tongue level so she won't have to hang her head.
Ah, I get it. That makes sense. I'm a producer at All Fours TV Network. You should be on TV, helping people to understand their animals better.
TV? Me?
If Martha's interested, come to this address with her parents or legal guardian.
What do you think? Interested?
People have trouble understanding animals. I could really help.
Are you sure this is it?
Albie's Shoe Repair, Alden's Barbershop, All Fours TV Network. There it is, Suite B2.
So glad you came. Martha's obviously a very special dog.
The All Fours Network shows only animal programs, right?
Down here on All Fours, we focus on four-legged animals. Therefore, we enforce a strict no-monkey policy.
I like it so far. What's my show?
You chat with people's problem pets, then tell people their pets' thoughts.
I chat with pets and then help people understand what's on their pets' minds. Huh? No, I understand. If you understand someone, you know what he or she means. She thought I was gonna stand on her.
Well, you certainly helped me understand Slappy's drinking problem.
I'd like to help people understand animals' thoughts.
So does that mean you'll do it?
You bet.
Good dog.
Having trouble comprehending your pet? I'm Martha, and I can help.
Conversing with a camel or comprehending cats, translating things for turtles or having chats with rats. Conversation dog, conversation dog, conversation dog.
That's me! Here's how I translate Caesar's thoughts. You snore like a foghorn factory, and he can't sleep. Let's chat, Cleo. What's on your mind? Try to comprehend this. Cleo doesn't want to be an indoor cat. She'd like to run free, get fleas, eat from trash cans.
Cleo!
Cats and trash belong together. Am I right? Okay, relax. I'll translate. Tom, here are Tony's thoughts. He doesn't like you making him work. He's only 2 years old.
But everyone races two-year-old horses.
I'm very sorry. Four-legged animals only.
Murray, I don't think camels are more popular than llamas.
Do we love llamas, people?
Yeah!
That's all the time we have for today. I'm Martha, the conversation dog, saying goodbye and keep wagging your tail.
What did you think, Mom?
I can't say I've ever seen a llama interviewed before. He had a lot on his mind.
Can I be on your show?
You don't have a pet.
Can I bring a parent?
Sorry about that, TD.
Aww. What is the use of knowing somebody famous if you don't get anything out of it?
Truman, why are you staring? You know Martha.
But now she's famous, Martha. On TV famous. Can I have your autograph, Martha TV dog?
Now I know how Santa Claus at the mall must feel. Helen, is everything gonna change now?
What do you mean?
I mean, with me becoming famous and the rest of you, you know, not.
I don't know. People may treat you differently. It's hard to know what people think.
But nothing will change with you and me, right?
No, Martha. We'll always be us, no matter what.
I only want good things to come out of this. Good night, Helen.
Good night, Martha.
I'm gonna ask Mr. Hucky if I can bend the rules and chat with that ostrich.
Hey, where is everybody?
Good morning. I have news about the first week's shows.
Mr. Hucky, where are the cameras, the problem pets, and that woman who combs me so well?
I didn't say I had good news. I just got our first week's ratings. You know what ratings are?
Isn't that how they count the number of people watching a show?
Yes. Here on All Fours TV, we even know how many animals watch, broken down by breed and weight.
Wonderful! So we know exactly how many animals I'm helping.
Yes, we know exactly how many. Overall...
How many collies watched? I like collies.
Collies? Zero. Look, overall...
What about labs? They're smart.
You had zero labs.
You didn't look at the ratings.
I don't have to. According to the ratings, only you and your friends watch your show.
Huh?
No animals?
Well, a gerbil in our control room would have been the only animal, but he turned his back and ate paper.
So, that's it? It's over?
No! I have changes here that will save your show. We're ready to go!
It's time for Martha's show. Change the channel.
This is Martha's show, Mom. They made some changes.
I don't know how to interpret these clues. Mind if I chat with the witness? Ma'am, can we have a little chat about what happened here? I understand. She says someone sly sheared the sleeping sheep. If we don't catch them, sheep everywhere will feel sheer terror. Crime scene doggy. ¿Qué es esto?
Turn it off.
Someone shy sleared the sheeping sleeps. Not easy to say.
Why can't I be happy like that?
He's happy because of you. That's why you're doing the show, so more people will understand animals.
But now it's just a show about driving fast, and they wouldn't even let me stick my head out the window.
Maybe you should chat with Mr. Hucky about it.
Tomorrow, I'll tell him I either interpret what people's pets are saying, or I quit. We need to talk, Mr. Hucky.
Oh, just a sec. The crime scene doggy ratings are in. Oh, my.
What are they?
The same. Zero. Research shows people don't want to watch any show with a talking dog.
I find that impossible to believe.
CSD is canceled. They canceled my other shows, too. CSC, CSO, and CSSW.
What are those?
Crime Scene Clam, Crime Scene Ostrich, Crime Scene Sperm Whale.
So is my TV career over?
That's how I'd interpret this.
All right! Let's go home, Helen!
So Martha's not special anymore?
Nope. I'm back to being just your friendly neighborhood talking dog.
Crime scene clam? Who wouldn't want to see a clam solve crimes?
People who own televisions, apparently.
If the network got 30 million emails, they'd bring it back?
I guess they'd have to.
I'll see you 2 weeks from Wednesday.
Hey, where are you going?
Home. I've got 30 million emails to write.
Let's see what show they put on instead of you.
And now, 3 more hours of Twine Kitten.
Twine Kitten? Who would watch that?
Let's go out and play catch.
Aww.
Strawberry shortcake, huckleberry pie. How many letters till your luck runs dry? A, B, C, D, E,
How does she do it?
What? Jump rope so long without tripping?
No, jump rope so long without getting hungry. Shortcake pie? Let's eat.
Whoa.
That was great.
Who wants a snack? Hey, guys, look what I got Martha and Skids. Isn't it cool?
Oh, yeah, cool.
Food? Trust me, wait till you see this in action. It's a flying squirrel toy. I got it at the air show.
I can't stand squirrels.
You're gonna love this one. Look, you put your fingers in here, pull, and off he goes! Holy hot dogs! Wow!
I think it's a hit!
My turn! Helen! Skits is hogging the toy! My turn!
You guys, you have to share!
Hear that? You're supposed to share. TD bought that toy for both of us, Skits. When he saw this toy, do you think he said, "Ooh, I hope this toy makes Skits and Martha fight"? No. I think, if I may speak for him, that he really wanted us both to have fun. He wanted us to share this toy. Because in the end, that is much more fun than being a big, stinky hog, isn't it, Skits? Gotcha! I wish they'd call a truce. It's so hard to concentrate with all that noise.
So, turn off the TV.
Turn off the TV? How am I supposed to do my homework without TV? It's still my turn. It's two. Helen, tell Skits it's my turn.
Hey! Why did you take it away? We were having so much fun.
Skits wasn't.
That was the fun part.
Martha, I can't believe you're being so selfish. The toy is going up here.
Till when?
Till you learn to play nice.
That could take forever!
I'm sorry, but your bickering is really annoying.
Bickering? We weren't bickering. Bickering means you fight about silly things.
That's what you were doing.
Was not.
We're two.
Was not.
We're... Now you've got me bickering.
Do not.
Do two. We have homework. You guys go play outside.
TD's just watching TV.
Outside.
No, it's your
fault. Hey, guys, check this out.
Because you wouldn't share.
Excuse me. I have to break up a quarrel. If you're gonna act like babies, I'm gonna treat you like babies. Hi, Truman.
Hello.
Mine. Hey, you guys, let's call a truce. You know what
a truce is, don't you? A truce is when people who are fighting agree to stop fighting.
Why are we watching this baby show?
Shh! Watch! Thank your mom for letting us watch this DVD.
When there's more than one, playing's more fun. When you share, when you share.
I'm glad Helen took her quarreling dog somewhere else. Now maybe I can concentrate on my homework.
It must be hard to be a dog, especially if the other dog is selfish and doesn't take turns.
I know. I can't stand when someone thinks they're the boss of you just because they're bigger.
Yeah. Wait. Martha is smaller than Skits.
Exactly. Skits is probably 3 times her size.
Wait. You think Skits was the selfish one?
Yeah. Who else?
Well, you guys, truce?
I won't fight if he won't fight.
What did he say?
He said he...
Skits is a big bully!
Yeah, well, just because Martha's older doesn't make her boss.
You're only sticking up for Skits because he's a boy.
What's going on?
TD says Martha's the one who won't share.
You're quarreling because of a dog toy?
We're not quarreling, we're fighting.
That's what quarrel means. It's when you fight.
It's not about a dog toy. It's a matter of principle.
Oh, yeah? Well, might does not make right.
Oh, yeah? Well, age does not make... Well, I can't think of a word that rhymes with age, but you're wrong.
Stop it! Stop it!
What is it, Martha?
Oh, not you guys. I'm having a quarrel with a flea. And I'm losing.
Who do you think is right, Helen?
Whoa, 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 whoa. You can't ask her.
Why not?
Because she'll take your side.
Why? Because I'm right?
No, because she's short. Like you. You all stick together.
You guys are being short? Since when am I short?
I'm just saying. Plus, Martha's a girl. Of course you're all gonna side with her.
I can't believe what I'm hearing. Helen, what do you think?
When there's more than one, playing's more fun. When you share, when you share.
Now, what did you learn?
I learned that girl puppets are selfish, too.
I learned that boys need someone to make them take turns.
And now, TD and Alice won't even speak to each other. I can't believe my friends are quarreling about a dog toy.
That's too bad.
I remember when I was in 5th grade, I built this model airplane with Dave Delashaw. When it was finished, we couldn't decide who got to keep it. Boy, did we bicker about that.
How'd you make up?
We didn't.
Where are you going?
To call Dave Delashaw. He's had that plane for 25 years. It's time that guy learned to share.
Back off!
Hey, what happened to your truce?
It broke. Stop breathing on it.
Aw, you're still doing it. Helen, Skits is breathing on the squirrel. We're too.
You guys, please.
Sorry, we're all ears.
Good, let's talk turkey.
Turkey? I love turkey.
It's an expression. It means to get down to business and talk about what's really going on.
Oh, okay.
So what's your beef with this toy?
Beef?
It's an expression. It means what's your problem?
Sorry, one track mind. The problem is we both want it, and we don't want to share.
Well, you have to negotiate something, or else I'm giving this back to TD.
No, don't! We'll negotiate. I swear, we'll negotiate.
What's negotiate?
Negotiate means you talk about a problem and agree on what to do.
Okay, we will. We promise.
Okay, Skits. I'll trade you my favorite squeaky baby for that squirrel.
Skits! We can't negotiate if you leave the room.
Alrighty, Roo. How about 2 squeaky babies and a rope toy?
Martha, are you bartering with Skits?
No, I'm not bartering. I'm trying to trade toys for the squirrel.
That's what bartering means. When you barter, you offer to give someone something if they'll give you another thing.
Oh, well then, yeah, I'm bartering. But so far, Skits doesn't want to trade.
This is my last offer, and then I'm not gonna barter anymore. I'll trade you two squeaky babies, a rope toy, and... a rawhide chewy!
Okay, okay, I get it. You're not interested.
But how about if I throw in that?
Hey, wait!
Whoa! Martha!
My toy!
You guys, you're supposed to negotiate a way to share that toy.
We did. I mean, we have.
How?
By not sharing it.
What? Hey! Martha?
Did you see that? I told you he was a selfish bully.
Skits isn't selfish. He's just trying to get his turn.
No, you guys, they're playing. At least, I think they're playing. You are playing, aren't you?
Yeah. It's a little game I invented. I call it Steal the Squirrel.
But you're tugging. That's not sharing.
We're dogs. This is about as sharey as we get. You should try it. Give it to Alice, Skits. You grab the other end. Now pull. And remember, no biting. Oh, don't just stand there. Run! Go get it! Fun, isn't it? Of course, you shouldn't play steal the squirrel with a dog you don't know. They might try and steal your hand.
I'm glad everyone's called a truce. There's just one problem.
What?
I want to play too!
Ha 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 ha!